Beautiful people, we made it. God damn it, we made it. We fucking made it. It's Friday, Average Guys Guide to Life podcast, and it's time for Freaky. Your faces are fucked up. Freaky Friday. Freaky. Time for Freaky Friday. This is going to be something we're going to do on a weekly basis, unless I get ill. We're going to have a freaky Friday. Once a week, every week. Unless someone decides to set me on fire or something like that. Maybe in the future we're going to do these live, so you can see my beautiful mug. But until then, this will have to suffice. So shut your face and listen to this advice. Actually, no, that's not what Freaky Friday is about. It's not about advice. It's about having motherfucking fun. Tons and tons. And it's also about sharing our stories with one another. And since you're not here to share yours, I'm going to share mine. Dating stories. Sexy stories. We're going to have some Punisher's journal thrown in here and there. And if you hear me make a pause like so, that's because I'm getting my sip on, man. And I'm going to be sharing with you what I'm sipping on at the moment today on this Friday, January 10th, 2020. Today I am with a fine Merlot, a wine today, Merlot of the, what is this shit, Barefoot variety. That's that shit you get at the corner store, liquor store. So that's what I'm doing today, getting some Merlot going and getting me some, this shit tastes like metal. I really don't like it, but it's not heavy. And it does make my shit, like, really black. Like, really, really black when I drink this. If that's too much information, then you will not like the direction this podcast is going. You will not be able to stomach it. It's not going to be shit stories, though. It's not going to be shit and poopy and pee-pee. It's not going to be that. So, yeah. I'm going to be sipping on this Merlot. Next week, it'll be something different. Week after that, it'll be something different. You get the fucking gist. Okay. I'm smoking my cigar. This is my Friday ritual, and now I am sharing it with you guys. All right? And we're going to have some freaky Friday fun. Or some... That's what we're going to have. You ever get the feeling like you stank? You know? Do you ever get that feeling like you stink? Or something? Maybe it's just me. I didn't light my cigar. Hold on. Maybe it's just me. But you ever see how people react around you? You know? Maybe they backing up a little bit. And you try to get a little private corner. Duck away somewhere and smell yourself. Do the pit check. Put your nose in your shirt. The fuck? Do I stink? The fuck's going on? I had one of those moments today. You know. Went to go drink some water. Drink a lot of water throughout the day. Drink a lot of fucking water. And I'm drinking it and I'm like, ugh, this water stink. Is that my breath? Because water don't have no smell. It's not supposed to. So that's my breath, right? It's fucking embarrassing. But it was a false alarm. I didn't stink. Someone around me that stunk. And it stunk so bad, the smell seeped into my fucking water. So there you go. I had one of those moments. All right, today on Freaky. Freaky Friday, this edition of The Average Guy's Guide to Life. We're going to be talking about a bunch of adult topics. All right. This ain't for your kids. Shit, this might not even be for your mama. Because she might be past her prime. This is some adult topics, if you get what I'm saying. And it's all fun, man. It's all fucking fun. Some of these stories may be related to me. Some may not. I may tell you, I may not. I got a question for you guys, though. And this one's for mostly the guys. Ladies, you may be able to chime in, but I don't think you would. Maybe you would. I caught someone doing this to me, I think. But it's about the technique of a certain thing that all men do. We all do it. We all do it. Don't you lie to yourselves, men. We all fucking do it. And we all got a different technique. And I want to know, what is your technique for peeking at them cheeks? What do you do? What would you do to get in those cheeks? What do you do, man? Are you one of those, you know, as soon as you walk past, try to get a quick glance, you know, like one of those split second looks? You know, you don't give her a chance to get too far because, you know, you're kind of blind. So you want to catch it while it's right there. So you do a split second, you know. Or you want a little slow, you know, as soon as you walk past, you do the slow turn over the shoulder, you know, and then look, give it about 2 seconds and then turn back, you know. Are you one of those guys that don't want them to know that you about to look, but you know you about to look because you know you saw it from the front, so you got to get a good look from the back. So you take a few steps, you know, not just one or two, like those quick glance guys. You take about 5 or 6, then you get a good long look when she think you're not. You know, she ain't looked back to look at you yet. You in the clear, so you can, if you far-sighted, you get a nice long look before she turned the corner. You know, you one of those guys? Or you one of those people that just reached a point where you don't give a fuck? One of those guys, you know? One of those guys that will do a full 180, turn around and stare, and dare you to stare back. I want to know. Once again, if you hear me pause, it's because I'm sipping. It's not because I'm choking on my own spit as usual. Excuse me once again. Ah. Oof. That shit tastes like heart disease. So what's your technique, fellas? What's your technique? Quick glance. Over the shoulder, slow glance, calculated stare, or no fucks given stare, 180 technique. I want to know. I'm not going to tell you my technique because if I got some female listeners out there, they got that ass, son. I ain't going to let you know. Well, I don't know. Quite frankly, I don't give a shit. I've implemented all of these techniques myself. I've implemented them all. It just depends on who I'm around, honestly. It just depends. If I'm with female company, I might do the methodical approach. If I'm with the boys, I might do the no fucks given 180 approach. If I'm by myself, I might do it a quick glance, you know, just to see if it's there. See if it's there, you know. Then turn back real quick. If I'm by myself again, you know, and I want you to know, I might do the slow over the shoulder. You know, you could feel the eyes burning. The eyes are burning a hole through the left and the right cheeks, that is. Fucking laser vision on them fuckers. You can feel that radiation from my eyeballs. Look at me. Look at me looking. Yeah, that's right. That's right. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Anybody ever seen that? Anybody ever seen that movie Anger Management with Adam Sandler and Jack Nicholson? Two of my favorite people. Soon as she looks back, I'm going to give her that Jack Nicholson nod. Like, yeah, that's right. I was looking. Yeah, I was waiting for you. I was waiting for you to turn back. And she's either going to be very creeped out or very aroused. It's never both. And if it is, if I meet a woman that it's both, I will marry her. Moving on. So now you get the premise of the freaky. So I wanted to share a story with you guys. So I'm not going to go full on rated TVMA on you guys. Not for the first Freaky Friday. Not for the first one. Maybe I will. I might change my mind later. But I want you guys to share with me your best and worst date stories. And today, I'm going to share with you one of each. One of each. Okay? Let's flip a coin to see which one am I going to share first. Fuck. See if I have a coin. You thought I was joking. I'm dead serious. All right, I found a quarter. Got a quarter here. All right. So heads, I'll tell the bad story. And tails, I'll tell the good story. All right. I'm going to give you the play-by-play on this. So the quarter is on my right index knuckle, the knuckle, not the one that makes the fist, the second knuckle there, and it's just sitting there waiting for me to flip it with my right thumb. All right, here we go. Heads. All right, I guess I'll start with the bad one first. Okay, so there was a time in which your boy was in I'm not going to say desperado mode, but, you know, I used to not be as interpersonal as I am currently. So I was doing the online thing. And upon doing the online thing, you meet a cast of fucking characters. You know how it goes. Anybody that's experimented with online dating, you know how it is. For women, it's a completely different experience. You have your pick of the litter, but normally that litter is fucking disturbing. They're either, what the fuck? I thought I silenced you. Hold on. Alright, that's better. I had to turn my goddamn phone off. So, for women, it's different. It's, you guys have the pick of the litter, but that litter is, fucking, you know, mental. They're disturbed. Some of them are creepos. Some of them are, what the fuck? I swear to God, can you guys hear that? Can you hear that? You hear that train? You know the crazy thing is, that fucking train, that horn that you hear, that train is 3 blocks away. 3 blocks. But I hear it like it's right fucking here. These buildings are made out of paper mache, I swear to God. I am so glad that I don't have a promiscuous neighbor. I haven't heard any Okay, let me not think about that. So, I was doing the online thing, and nowadays, you gotta kind of roll the dice. You never really know what you're getting yourself into, so you gotta vet. You gotta vet motherfuckers hard, you know? You gotta know what they're about, what they think they're about, what they think they're about, you know? You gotta get really, really deep into the life. You know, you gotta pry. You gotta be pry. There is no private information. I mean, there is some, but you gotta know. 'Cause some people fucking out here crazy, man. Crazy. You don't want to wake up missing organs and shit in a bathtub. You don't want that. You don't want to, you know, end up being burned either on your genitals or burned alive because it's a fucking pyromaniac. So you got to be careful. So I met this young lady who I thought was my cup of tea. You know, Lipton. Two sugars. Scorching hot. Key words. Scorching and hot. Okay. I am admittedly sort of kind of shallow. But everyone is. Everyone has their type. Everyone is entitled to their type. Fuck you. Fuck you. Don't judge me. Everyone has a type. Even if your type is not my type, your type might be fucking crispy, crispy black. You know, that's not my type. Not my type. Okay. So we get along. We gabbing, you know, chatting up a storm. She understands my warped sense of humor and my sarcasm, knows not to take me too seriously. I understand hers. She's sort of like me, kind of disturbed, but also very logical. Understand how the world moves. Latina, she was. And we decided, fine, let's meet up and go for some hookah. Let's go to the hookah lounge, okay? So I take a chance. I'm like, fuck it. You only live once. Let me go meet this motherfucker. So I go and I arrive early. On purpose, just in case we have an issue and I have to abort the mission, okay? That way I could see it from afar, you know? But it was fucking cold at this time. It was maybe February and it was freezing, so I couldn't stand outside and just look and wait. So I'm like, fuck, fuck, I gotta go inside. I gotta go inside the hookah lounge and wait in there. So now the escape route is not as well planned as I would have liked. Now I would actually have to make an excuse to leave if the mission need to be aborted. So she arrives. Now, let me backtrack a little bit. This person, okay? This person looked like she could be a supermodel in the pictures. Supermodel figure, face, everything. Okay. About 5'4", 120, 125. That's what she looks like in the pictures. Upon meeting this person, she was about 5'4". 250. Now, what do I do here? What do I do here, women? What do I do here? Do I open up immediately acknowledging the fact that you've edited your photos or you've taken them in some sort of warped position, angle to make yourself look like you're something you're not? You filtered the fuck out of your face to make you look like something you're not. Do I open up the conversation with that? Do I remain friendly and just try to make it through the day, make it through the date without there being any uncomfortable, awkward tension? Okay. I choose option two. I choose to try and make it through the date, but also not to lead this person on to the road because there was nothing happening. My dick was sound asleep. He might have fucking shrunk. And we were in a warm place at this moment. He crawled up inside my body and wanted nothing to do with it. Nothing. Nothing to do with that at all. But she didn't get the gist. So, long story short, for this one of many, many bad dates I've been on, I had to call. I had to call for a fucking lifeline. So I ended up calling my friend and I texted my friend. I was texting him under the table while the date was going on because I guess I was a little too friendly and she didn't realize that nothing was happening. Like I gave off a strictly friend vibe, you know, but she was giving me these flirty vibes and I was like, So I was texting my friend at the table. I'm like, dog, you gotta fucking call me. Like, pretend there's something going on. And this fucker doesn't get it. Like, he doesn't understand what's going on. And I told him earlier I was going on this mystery date, even though I've seen the profile pictures, but those are as good as fucking garbage when you're dealing with technology. So I'm trying to explain to him while keeping eye contact with the person I'm technically on a date with. And I'm texting him on the table completely with thumbtap memory while not trying to break the eye contact. Telling him, dude, fucking call me now. Why? Why do I have to call you? Just do it. It's an emergency. Pretend that the house is on fire. Something. So he, I don't know if he was being a jackass, but he wouldn't call me. He just wouldn't. I don't know if he was trying to fucking have some fun at my expense, but it was not fun at all. It was not fun. So I had to call him. So that put a fucking crack in my plans. Didn't look as pretty as I wanted it to. So I called him and pretended like he texted me something important. So I called him and I walked outside and I was like, fucking dude, come get me. This is a mistake. it's the fucking laundry sack of a person out in there waiting for me. I need you to bail me out like right now. And the bad part was I think she got the vibe. Once I walked out and made that phone call. So it was really awkward when she had walked out and caught me on the back end of that phone call. Like, she didn't hear anything insulting. It was just, I was laughing. So she knew it was, like, some other shit going on. And it was just really awkward when my friend came to finally pick me up. And we sped away from the fucking scene like we robbed the bank. It was horrible. Horrible. For that, I need some Milo. Let me take a little sip of that. So yeah, that was fucking horrible, guys. Thank goodness that was over. Now let me tell you one of the good stories. Once again, this is me during that around that same period, maybe a year or two before, where I was strictly doing the online thing. Strictly doing the online thing, right? Now, I had met someone on this site that probably is fossilized by this point. It used to be called Urban Chat. And it's a place for urbans to chat. Urbans, you know, niggas. The fucking niggas. The niggas. Or the Ricans. The Mexicans. You know, people that listen to the fucking hippity hop. So it was all us there and a few honkies. Honk. I don't mean to offend. I offend everybody across the board, okay? So don't take offense to anything I'm saying. If you do, fuck you, pussy. So I met someone who was a legit 10. Fucking 10, 10, 10, 10. Ren 10, 10, 10, 10. So I'm thinking, okay, this person has to be a shallow, run of the mill, wannabe spoiled, materialistic, looking for a sugar daddy type of girl. And this was before, the boom of internet dating, hence why I was on Urban Chat and not on anything else. So that sugar baby lifestyle was just starting to kind of come about. Like it was still, excuse me, it was still in its infant stages. But I wasn't aware of any of it, so I go into this situation completely with blind ambition and optimism, thinking that, whatever, I'm gonna take my fucking shot, even if it is from full court. You only get one shot. Lo and behold, this person was actually a decent human being. Now, the other part of my brain was thinking, okay, this has to be a fucking fake profile. Why the fuck is this Ren 10 10 10 10 10 talking to me? I'm not an ugly guy by any means, but I'm not fucking Jason Momoa, And she looked like she would be dating Jason Momoa. Once again, another Latina. La, 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 la. She was born, I don't know why I just did that. She was a Puerto Rican young lady, and she was very, very, very attractive, like extremely curvaceous. She actually had some amateur modeling pictures on her profile. So I'm thinking this has to be a fucking fake profile. So now my fucking red alarm is going off above my head, and I'm trying to verify this person as quickly as possible. So we start texting, and they asking for verification of identity via those text messages. So they send me the same pictures that's on their profile, and I'm scratching my head like, do I come off as a fucking thirst noob by continually asking for pictures? I don't know what a thirst noob is. I was going somewhere with that, but it just kind of failed halfway through. I don't want to harass someone by continuously asking them for pictures. Or do I just accept the fact that they're sending me something that's already on their profile? While this entirely different conversation is going on in my head, the main conversation is this person is actually fucking cool. They're a nice, decent human being, down to earth. So I'm like, fuck it. We need to do this right now. We need to meet as soon as possible. Maybe a week go by after we've been talking. So we decide that after she got off of work, we were going to meet up at a motherfucking China buffet. Her idea, mind you. I wanted to take her somewhere nice. She said, no, the China buffet is right down the street from where I work. Why don't we just go there? You seem like my type of girl, You look fancy, but you're not fancy. What? They make you? They fucking make you? Where? But then the other conversation is going on in my head. This bitch must be 700 pounds. You want to go to the China buffet? Red alert. Red alert. You know what I'm saying? Fuck type of. Like, you want to go to the China buffet on the first date? You hungry, bitch? You hungry? Anyway, so I say, fuck it. I'm gonna do it. So I show up early, like I always do, to plan my escape route, just in case I gotta get away. Now, she pulls up, knew what type of car she was driving because she told me, and I'm waiting outside in front, just like down, I'm in a corner, like I'm in the corner of this strip mall. Like maybe two stores down from the China buffet, so I could see her walk to it. I know I am a creep, so I could see them get out the car and walk to it. And she got out the car. She was dressed in her work clothes, and she looked exactly like her pictures. I was like, holy shit. Okay, so I walked down there, told her, and when you first meet someone especially when you meet someone that is almost intimidatingly attractive. You're kind of awkward and fumbly, you know? Well, I'm not like that anymore. I used to be that way when I was younger. And there was that you would expect some sort of awkwardness at first. It's like, they're fucking hot. How do they think I look? Or, you know, will they think I'm fucking corny or whatever? I was expecting that vibe. But as soon as we linked eyeballs, it was like fucking fireworks, dude. Fireworks. I couldn't explain it. And we got into this China buffet. The service was horrible. There was like a football or soccer team amount of kids like running around and shit. There was food on the floors and on the tables. I shit you not. But we couldn't see any of that. Like, if anything, we used it as comic relief. And we were just fucking joking about it. Like, how the fuck did we end up here? It was something that it's hard to explain unless you've had it. It was an instant vibe. You know, that those sparks that people talk about, you know, this was that. This was that. It was unusual. And we talked. Like, there was no awkward silences. There was no, you know, oh, and what do I talk about now type of moment. It was all flowing and vibing well. And mind you, this is a 10-10. And I am at best a Chicago 7.5. 8 if I'm in shape when I choose to be. But she was, whew, another level. So we stay there for about an hour and a half. We get in the car. She drops me off home. Didn't complain. Didn't ask for gas money. And we talked for about an hour outside of her car. Just talked. And it wasn't any awkward pauses. And we just kissed. We just fucking kissed. Oh, that's so sweet. Yeah, we fucking locked eyes and we kissed. She went halfway. I went halfway and we fucking went for it. It was nice. It's a nice. It was. It was. So that is one of the good ones, people. If you would like to know what happened to her in that situation, maybe I'll do a follow-up on another episode of It's Freaky Freaky Friday. Maybe, if you ask me. If you don't, I don't give a shit. Or maybe you can wait for my book to come out, What the Fuck Just Happened, when, which is an anthology of all of my dating fails and successes, but mostly fails because fails are funny. And I am seriously in the midst of producing that book for you guys. So be on the lookout for What the Fuck Just Happened. But it won't be entitled What the Fuck. It will be WTF Just Happened. So be on the lookout for that. It's good. It's going to be good. And if you want to follow up on that story, let me know. I have no secrets, folks. Well, I do have one major, major secret. But I'll never tell. And now it's time for the very first edition of The Punisher's Journal.
Punisher's Journal, January 2008. Just got a job, part-time. Working as a tax professional. Greedy people trying to cheat on their returns. Claiming children that aren't theirs. Only to get screwed by the government at the end. It pays well. Current time, 3 p.m. Time to clock out. Currently, in a dry spell. No pussy. No head. Not for months. Almost a year. The urge is starting to become unbearable. Luckily, Punisher's been courting rancid cunt, whore, known for giving great blowjobs. Hoping to get lucky tonight. Punisher takes the bus. Public transportation for losers. Currently, Punisher is a loser. Getting no pussy. Working part-time. Barely paying phone bill. Giving off the impression that I do more than I do so that I can get the pussy. Do anything for the pussy at this point. Punisher checks while on bus. Where are you at? The response puts a grin on Punisher's face. I'm at home, waiting for you. Punisher takes it as she's at home, waiting for dick. My dick. This dick. She's waiting on. Punisher arrives. 5 p.m. Almost time to get in the sweet spot. Punisher arrives at the doorstep, meets frantic cunt, pretends to like her, pretends that she's a princess, says anything to get the pussy, anything. Lies are only white lies. If you know they're lies, they don't have to know. Not until it's too late. Not until you hit the cheeks. Punisher welcomed in house. House is somewhat clean. Punisher can tell that she lives with older people. People who care about appearances, because she clearly does not. Ponytail is stingy. Tank top is dingy. But her ass is fat. Punisher dick throbs. Need to get pussy now. Punisher desperation. Trying to hide. Don't want to reek of it. She invites me in the bedroom, offers me food, pizza rolls. Punisher doesn't want fucking pizza rolls. Punisher wants pizza cunt. Punisher turns down food, gets comfortable in bed, cuddles. Punisher is the big spoon. She can feel dick pointing. She knows it's there. Punisher can't hide protruding penis. Pokes her in spine. She knows what's next. A bunch of digging. Punisher gets the cheeks. Punisher punishes cheeks. Rancid cunt acts unusual requests. Wants jizz. Inside the sweet spot. Confused by request, Punisher does not oblige. He pulls out and squirts wherever it goes. Eyes are closed. Punisher does not know. Lo and behold, rancid cunt wanted jizz inside her sweet spot. Because she was carrying another man's child. You can't make this shit up. Punisher's log. End of entry. Next time, I'll wear a rubber.
All right, beautiful people. That was it for our freaking your faces and fuck that Friday. Hopefully you guys are going into a good weekend. Hopefully you guys are going to do what I advised you to do, my goal, on the previous episode. And go do some fun shit too, man. Do some fun shit, relax. Everybody's working for the weekend. And it's here. This has been the Average Guy's Guide to Life podcast. Thank you for listening. If you want to, you can, you know, follow me on the Instagrams or whatever the fuck. I don't care. We out.